Good morning to everyone. We are going to continue the basics of virtualization in this session. On behalf of the virtualization concepts, what we have learned in the previous session, it is about we can able to experience the physical experience of using a particular machine. Being we are using that machine through the help of a software application, we will be getting the feel of operating the machine as physically. This may lead to the rise of the administrative costs. Because of that, the virtualization have been boomed into the market. In specific to the administrative cost, what it happens is the power consumptions and then the cooling cost are higher than on using the IT equipment. The increasing the demand for the additional capacity, which translate into more servers in a data center. So for that, we are moving to the we need a virtual server or a virtual PC is needed. Because of these issues, virtualization plays a major role here. And then computers in particular, servers do not operate all on their own, and then they require care and feeding from the system administrators. Common system administrative task includes hardware monitoring, defective hardware replacement, server setup and updates, server reserve monitoring, resource monitoring and backups. And then labor intensive operations are done, huge number of servers that have to be managed, and then the higher the administrative cost. So with this, the virtualization can help to reduce the number of required servers for giving a workload. And then the cost is also reduced in case of the administrative personnel. The characteristics of virtualized environment. The major components for the virtualized environment are three major components. They are guest, host and then virtualization layer. In guest, it represents the system component that interacts the virtualization layer rather than with the host, as could normally happen. The host represents the original environment where the guest is supposed to be managed. And then the virtualization layer is responsible for recreating the same or different environment where the guest will operate. In case of the virtualization hardware, the guest is represented by the system image comprising an operating system and installed applications. They are installed on the top of the virtual hardware and they are controlled and managed by virtualization layer. So far we are called that as a virtual machine manager, and the host is instead represented by the physical hardware. And in some case of the operating system, they define the environment where the virtual machine manager is running. In case of virtual storage, a guest might be the client applications or user that interact with the virtual storage management software. In case of virtual networking, how the guest applications and the users interact with the virtual network happens is through the VPN, that is a virtual private network. And then these VPNs are useful for creating the illusion of being within a different physical network and then accessing the resources in it which could be otherwise not available. So we will be feeling that we are accessing the resources physically. So that's what happens with the virtual network. The functionalities of a virtualization and its advantages are increased security, that is the virtual machine with the emulated environment in which the guest is executed makes increased security, and then the virtual machine manager helps to control and filter the activity of guest, thus preventing some harmful operations from being performed. And then what are the things it can, the features of the virtualization is it manages the execution. So how far it is managing is sharing, aggregation, emulation and then isolation. So virtualization allows the creation of separate computing environments within the same host. Within the same host you can able to share the resources of whatever the application is needed for. And then for aggregation, the virtualization allows a group of separate hosts to be tied together. So we'll be having a group where the hosts will be tied together, and then each will be having an represented as a guest to make as a single virtual host. And then their function is that they make the harnesses of the physical resources of your homogeneous group, which represents them as a single resources. Emulation, which is the guest programs, are executed within an environment that is controlled by the virtualization layer. So with the emulation, what it happens is the hardware virtualization solutions are able to provide the virtual hardware and emulate a particular kind of device, such as a small computer system interface. And then regarding the isolation part, the virtualization allows providing a guest where they are the operating systems and then applications and other entities with a completely a separate environment in which they will be executing. So it makes the multiple guests to run on the same host without interfering with each other. So that's a part of the isolation. So and then next is performance tuning. So with the help of this virtualization, QoS is achieved in a higher way. However, it will be like a hypervisors where the virtual machine managers can able to stop the execution of any guest operating systems, which is virtually executing and independently without depending upon others, they will be executing. The execution is transparent in manner. However, it is supports a portability characteristics. That is, in case of hardware virtualization solution, the guest is packed into the virtual image. And then it makes the users to have their own system always with them and ready to use as long as required. Thank you.